In this video, I'm going to explain how transformers work and show you how to wire one up to step mains voltages down to lower voltages that your projects may need. In my project, we'll step down 120 volts to 24 volts, but the same principles will apply to most transformers. I'll also give you a quick peek at how you can go from mains electricity to creating a dual rail DC power supply. So, what is an electrical transformer? A transformer is a device that takes electricity, turns it into a magnetic field, then turns it back into electricity again. Depending on how the transformer is designed, you can use them to step up voltages, step down voltages, or even keep the voltages the same if all you want is electrical isolation from your wall outlet. So, basically, transformers help you get from one voltage to another. And when you remove the protective casing, all transformers end up looking kind of like this, with a bunch of wires wound around an iron or ferrite core. Next, I want to talk a little bit more about how transformers work. Transformers only work with AC. An AC voltage on the input creates an expanding and collapsing magnetic field within the transformer's core. Now, when you put this alternating magnetic field in the presence of another coil, the moving magnetic flux will induce electrical current into the secondary coil, so you'll get another AC voltage on the output. Here I have a transformer that takes 120 volts on the input and gives you 12 volts on the output, so we call it a step-down transformer. Now, just for fun, I'm going to use a crappy magnetic field probe, and if I move it near a transformer that's in use, you can see the magnetic field expanding and collapsing at 60 Hz. That's because stray magnetism is inducing current into my probe. The same thing is happening on the secondary side of the transformer, but obviously more efficiently, so I get the full 12 volts. But with DC, the magnetic field would stay still, so no current would be induced in the secondary coil, and nothing would happen. Now let's move on to a more conventional circuit diagram. The simple theoretical model of a transformer will usually show you the turns ratio. The turns ratio is how you know if you're stepping voltage up or down, and by how much. And when I say turns, I mean literally the number of times the wire was wound around the transformer's core. The left side is called the primary side, and this is where you connect your input voltage. The right side is called the secondary side, and this is where you connect your load. Now, in school, they'll tell you that the ratio of V in to V out is the same as the ratio of primary turns to secondary turns. So if you have a transformer with a 10 to 1 ratio, it will divide the input voltage by 10, and that's what you'll get on the output. With the simple theoretical model of transformers, the turns ratio is all that matters, so here's an easy formula for you to use in your homework. Now, the problem is, if you actually want to build stuff, that's all bullshit, because if you try to build a transformer solely based on those equations, all you'll get is this. In the real world, transformers behave a lot more like this, or this, or sometimes this. It gets complicated. In other words, transformers have all kinds of inductances, resistances, capacitances, and magnetic hysteretic effects, and if you're new to working with transformers, you should be buying a brand new transformer specifically designed for your purposes. Don't try to salvage transformers off of old PCBs and expect them to work with mains voltages. Transformers tend to work best only at certain frequencies. So, let's talk about how to buy a transformer for your first project. For the rest of this tutorial, I'm going to be working with a transformer that I bought to convert 120 volts at 60 Hz AC down to 24 volts AC. You could use a transformer like this as part of a homemade guitar amplifier, or possibly a bench power supply. You can get transformers like this at jamaco.com, and you can also get them at Parts Express. And in Canada, I got mine from Lee's Electronic. Just search for transformer and you'll see various options with different output voltages and current ratings. If you see the term CT, or numbers like 12012, that means it's a center tap transformer, which means you'll have the choice of having the full 24 volts AC, or splitting it up into two 12 volt supplies. More on that later. Now, if your transformer is rated in VA instead of amps, you might be wondering what that means. Well, basically you can think of VA as being equal to the power rating of the transformer in watts. Now, that's technically incorrect, but for anything a beginner is designing, they might as well be the same thing. So, if you think your project will draw 50 watts, buy a 75 VA transformer so you have a bit of a safety margin. If you want more information on what VA means, Google volt ampere and power factor. Working backwards, for the 45 VA transformer I bought here, the max load that I would try to put on it is about 30 watts just for the sake of having a nice safety margin. And I should probably keep an eye on the temperature too. So pick your voltages, figure out how much current your transformer needs to handle, and buy your transformer so I can show you how to wire it up. Okay, got your transformer? Let's do a quick review of mains electricity. If you live in North America, you'll have power cables that look like this on the inside. The black wire is the live wire that carries electricity into your home. The white wire is the neutral wire for the return path of the current. And the green wire connects to the earth, or literally the ground, and is used as a safety feature in some appliances. For what we're doing today, you don't need to worry about the earth wire. In Europe, the wires do the same thing, but the color convention is different. The live wire is usually brown, the neutral wire is usually blue, and the earth wire is green and yellow. Okay, so let's do a quick test of the wiring here. I've got my multimeter set to measure AC volts, and I've double-checked that the cable is in the volts jack, not in the amps jack. I'm making sure that there's no way that the wires could possibly touch and short out while I'm measuring, and I've clipped and taped off the earth wire because I'm just not using it for this project. Finally, remove any wire clippers from the area. If I plug it in, I should see roughly 120 or 240 volts. Good, it worked. Once I'm done with that, I unplug things because it's not a good idea to leave exposed power wires lying around more than you have to. Now, let's talk about how to connect those wires to the primary windings of a step-down transformer. Here's a diagram of my transformer and a picture of the real thing. If you have 120 volt electricity and wire the transformer up like this, it'll work just fine. You'll get your 24 volts out and it'll be totally usable. However, you can only use the transformer at half the power rating. If you want to use your transformer at its full capacity, you'll have to wire two pairs of live and neutral wires to the primary. Now, why did they do that? Why did they make life difficult with those extra windings? Well, if you have 240 volt electricity like in Europe and Asia, you'll have to wire things differently. Connecting the wires like this will change the ratio of the transformer turns, so you'll still get 24 volts out instead of 48 volts out. So basically, this is a transformer that can be used at two different input voltages by making connections to the primary coils differently. But not every transformer will be like this. Some transformers will not give you the option of having multiple configurations on the primary side or the secondary side. I already showed you an example of a transformer I ripped out of an old boombox. All it does is take 120 volts and spit out 12 volts. This is a nice and easy solution, but at least if you know how windings work, you'll be able to use all kinds of transformers in future, not just the easy stuff. So, let's solder things up. Here's my soldering job, and if you want, you can also put a fuse in line with a live wire. Okay, so now the primary is wired up. Let's put the safety goggles on, stand back, plug it in, and see what happens. Nothing! Excellent! Zero fatalities, a new record. Now, let's see what's happening on the secondary side. Well, on the outer terminals, we're getting about 27 volts AC, and that should drop down to 24 once you put a load on it. Excellent. So if that's all you want, you can just solder some wires to these terminals, ignore the center terminal, and you'll have 24 volts RMS AC for your project. Also, since the secondary side is isolated from the mains, it's now safe for me to clip on my oscilloscope probes to take a look at the actual waveform. And for safety's sake, do not connect your oscilloscope's ground clip to the primary side of the transformer while you are doing this. You will create a small explosion if you do that. On the secondary side of things, let's connect the bottom terminal to ground and measure the voltage at the top terminal. Well, we get a nice sinusoid as expected, and this is a good reminder that RMS voltage is not the same thing as peak-to-peak voltage. The 27 volts RMS figure is helpful for knowing how much power you will be able to deliver to a resistive load, and the peak-to-peak voltage of 78 volts tells me that the rest of my circuit will need components that can handle 78 volts later on. For example, I'll need 100 volt capacitors as an absolute minimum to handle those 78 volt peaks. Now, I promised to talk more about center tap transformers, so here we go. Do you see how the label says 12.012 volts? Well, instead of calling the outer terminal ground, let's call the center terminal ground and see what's happening on the oscilloscope. The two waveforms are in opposite polarity. They're also about 39 volts peak to peak, which is half of the 78 volts that we were getting earlier. This makes sense because we're effectively splitting the secondary coil into two pieces and measuring voltages with respect to the center tap. So having a center tap transformer gives you the option to have a negative voltage at the exact same time that you have a positive voltage, and this is very useful when designing dual rail power supplies. Now check this out. If I add a couple of diodes and capacitors, and measure the voltage coming off the capacitors, now I have a dual rail plus and minus 18 volt DC power supply. It's a crude one, but for low currents it will work. So I'm going to talk more about diodes and power supplies in future videos, so stay subscribed and thank you for watching. If you follow my advice, your experience with transformers should be better than Sully's was.